Welcome! In this video tutorial, we're going to have a look at how to remove blank rows from a table of any size in a couple of seconds. This way, you'll make the spreadsheet look neat and data in it organized. Ready to start? Hi there, and welcome to EasyClick Academy. My name's Maria, and together with our EasyClick team, we're here to make sure you'll be able to use Excel in a quick and easy way, thanks to our digestible video tutorials. It's very easy to delete rows one by one, which you could see in the previous tutorial on how to delete rows in Excel. However, that works best if there are just a couple of rows to remove. Now we'll have a look at how to delete a bigger number of blank rows from a large table easily. And not only that, you'll also learn how to handle a common but unexpected difficulty which happens when you're trying to delete multiple rows. Keep watching. You won't find this life hack in other YouTube tutorials. So, let's start from the beginning. If you want to remove the blank rows in a table, go to Home tab, Group Editing, and click on Find and Select. Click on Go to Special. From the options available, choose Blanks, and confirm with OK. Every blank row in the table will get highlighted. All you need to do now is to click on the option Delete in the Home tab section Cells, and choose Delete Sheet Rows. Good job! The whole table has been immediately cleared from the blank rows. But watch out! Here's the big problem you might encounter while deleting multiple blank rows from a table, and other YouTube tutorials won't tell you about it. Undo the changes, and we'll show you what can go wrong. Those quick steps you learned a short while ago are okay to use then and only then, when all the rows you're planning to delete are completely empty, which means none of the cells in these rows contain any data. If there were both blank and filled cells in a row to be deleted, you could easily lose these data. We're going to show you now what actually happens with these partially filled rows. Let's write figure 555 in the cell D5. Row 5 now consists of mostly blank cells, but also a cell that contains a value. If we now follow the steps we saw previously, Excel deletes the row 5 because it detects some blank cells in it, so our number 555 has been lost. If your data table contains such partially filled rows, watch our advanced video tutorial that will show you how to handle a situation like this and not to lose important data when deleting rows in Excel. If you found this tutorial helpful, give us a like and watch other video tutorials by EasyClick Academy. Learn how to use Excel in a quick and easy way. Is this your first time on EasyClick? We'll be more than happy to welcome you in our online community. Hit that subscribe button and join the EasyClickers. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.